NCM Learning Center. Good morning, friends. NCM Learning Center continuously providing materials, preparation tips, notifications for the government examinations. NCM Learning Center have WhatsApp group. Through WhatsApp group, you can clarify your doubts. In this video, I am going to discuss about maximum power transfer theorem concepts. The maximum power transfer theorem concepts will be very useful for EEE, ECE and instrumentation students. The maximum power transfer theorem concepts have various cases. Now I will explain each cases one by one. So let me discuss. The condition for the maximum power transfer theorem is, the first condition is, if the power factor of the circuit is unity, the maximum power will be transferred. Okay. The second condition is, already we know that max concepts, mathematics. You have to differentiate this power by using any one of the variable. If the circuit have load resistance variable, you have to differentiate the power by load resistance and equal to zero. If the circuit have reactance variable, you have to differentiate the power by load reactance. If the circuit have impedance variable, you have to differentiate the power by load impedance. Okay, this is the second condition, this maximum minimum concepts. If any circuit met out both the condition, the power transfer will be maximum. So first case is, if the source and load is fully resistive and load resistance are variable. Let us take these circuits. Here Thevenin circuit is taken. Okay, for easiest analysis, here this is source. Source and load are purely resistance. The load resistance is variable. For that case, what will be the maximum power transfer? The first condition, power factor of the circuit should be unity. Here the circuit have, there is no inductive and capacitive component. All the element in the circuits are resistive element. So already the circuit have unity power factor. Okay. So no need to adjust any one of the variable to make the power factor of the circuit is unity. Okay. Already the power factor of the circuit is unity. The second condition, we have to differentiate the power of the circuits by variable R. So first find power, or P is equal to I square R, already we know that. Here I is equal to, I is equal to Lebesgue concepts, Ohm's law. So here R is equal to RTH plus RL, both are in series. So P is equal to VTH by RTH plus RL. Substitute here, we will get V is equal to VTH by RTH plus RL, the whole square into R. Now differentiate the circuit by RL. Here this is UV format, U V dash plus V U dash. Differentiate and equal to 0, we will get RTH is equal to RL. Okay, remember this. When RTH is equal to RL, the power will be maximum. This is a condition for the circuits. Next, to find the amount of maximum power transfer, substitute this RTH values in this equation. We will get P is equal to VTH by RTH plus RTH, 2 RTH the whole square into RTH. You will get P is equal to VTH square by 4 RTH square into RTH. So RTH will cancel. You will get P is equal to VTH square by 4 RTH. Now do it yourself. This question is asked in gate 2010 examination, I think. To be an instrumentation. So here the circuit have load resistance. Load is purely resistance. Source also field resistance, but the source have multiple sources. So first to find the Thevenin circuits, but no need to find VTH. Okay, don't waste the time for the calculation of VTH. When RTH is equal to RL, the power will be maximum. The second case, here source and load are impedance, load resistance and reactance are individually variable. For the case, what will be the maximum power transfer? By the concept, the first condition is, the power factor of circuit should be unity. So here there is an inductive component. If the circuit have only resistive element, the power factor of the circuit will be unity. So adjust XL to nullify the total reactance value. So if XL is equal to minus XS, the total reactance value will be zero. The circuit will be only resistive element. Next, adjust RL is equal to RS by the case 1, the power will be maximum transfer. Okay. This is a condition for the maximum power transfer for the circuits. The amount of maximum power transfer will be reactive component value is 0. So with P max is equal to VTK square by 4 RTK. It's the same concepts. Here RTK is equal to RS. Third case, here source and load are impedance, but the load resistance and reactive are not individually variable. combined variable. What will be the condition for the maximum power transfer? For circuits, if ZL value is the complex conjugate of the source impedance, the power will be maximum power transfer. Because ZL is equal to RS minus JX. If ZL is equal to RS minus JX, this J, the X source impedance, this value will be compensated. So that there is no reactive effect. RL is equal to RS. So definitely the power will be maximum power will be transferred. Like these concepts. Okay. Do it yourself. This question asked in GATE ECE 2007 examinations. Fourth case. This source are impedance, but load is purely resistive variable. What will be the condition for the maximum power transfer? In this concept, we cannot nullify the reactive command value. So, goes to second condition directly. Find the power and differentiate this equal to RL and equal to 0 will get when the source impedance, magnitude of source impedance is equal to magnitude of load impedance, the power factor will be maximum. Remember these concepts. When the load impedance is equal to source impedance, RTK is equal to RL. Similarly, here impedance. When load impedance is equal to source impedance, the power will be maximum, power will be transferred. Here load impedance is equal to RL, but source impedance is equal to root of R square plus JX square, impedance square. In this condition, maximum power will be transferred. Remember these concepts, okay? This case will be very important one. Right? First question is asking GATE 2013 examinations. If you don't know the fourth case, definitely your answers for the first question will be wrong. Because here, source resistance is 4. When source resistance is equal to load resistance, maximum power will be transferred. So, we will write RL is equal to 4 ohm. But the answer is wrong. Because RL should be root of R square plus X square. Okay. Second question is asking GATE 2015 ECE department examinations. Here, source impedance are not in series. So, find Thevenin's impedance. Then use the case, fourth case. Okay. And case 5. This is very important case. These concepts is not available in the olden books. So listen carefully. The load have impedance with voltage source. For the case, what will be the maximum power transfer? Just first I will explain the procedures, then I will solve one problem. You can clearly understand. The first step, they replace the load impedance with the voltage source by a new impedance without voltage source. Just like this. RL dash XL dash. The impedance with the voltage source replaced by an impedance. Now easiest to calculate the maximum power transfer for the circuits. We know that case 2. To get the maximum power transfer, first power factor circuit should be unity. So adjust XL dash is equal to minus XS, RL dash is equal to RS. In this condition, the maximum power will be transferred for the circuits. Third, find the current at the maximum power transfer condition. Okay. Now RL dash is equal to RS here, XL dash is equal to minus XS. This XL and this value will be 0. Reactance components, reactive value is equal to 0, total reactance is 0. So IM is equal to by Ohm's law VTH by R, R is equal to RS plus RS. 2RS. This is the current. Now, the same current, the current at the maximum power transfer condition flows in the circuit. Definitely, the circuit's power will be maximum power. So, now consider this old circuits with voltage source. Find the circuit parameter at the current IM. Find RL and XL when IM current flows in the circuits. If IM current flow in the circuits means the maximum power will be transferred. So now we will solve a problem. Get questions. Here This circuit A is a source, circuit B is load. The load have an voltage source. The first step, replace the load by new impedance without voltage source, like this. Okay, R and XL series. Now this is easiest to find maximum power transfer condition. When XL is equal to XS, the power will be maximum power will be transferred. If there is no XS, XS value is 0, so equal to 0. When RL is equal to RS, the power will be maximum power will be transferred, so 2 ohms. In this condition, the maximum power will be transferred. Okay. Now, third steps, find IM value, current at which the maximum power transfer condition. Okay. The substitute value here, XL is equal to 0, RL is equal to 2 ohms. Now, value, what is the value of IM? IM is equal to 10 divided by 4. Okay, I will be by R concepts. So IM is equal to 2.5 amps. Step 4, consider this olden circuits. If the IM current flows here, definitely this circuit will be transferred the maximum power transfer. Find R value at which IM current flow. Here IM is equal to 2.5. Apply Kirchhoff's voltage law around this loop to calculate the R value. Apply KVL. 2 into IM plus R into IM plus 3 minus 10 is equal to 0. Substitute IM is equal to 2.5, R is equal to 0.8. Option A is correct. This is a procedure to calculate the maximum power transfer. The load have the voltage source. Now I listed the old exam questions. Just try those questions. Come on, your answers. The first question is asked in GATE 2021 examinations. Here load or pure resistive element, but the source or impedance. The source impedance are in series parallel form, so you have to convert this into series form by using Thevenin's resistance calculations. The second question is case 5 concepts. Replace the load by RL. When RL is equal to RTH, the maximum power will be transferred. Find the current. At this current, what will be the value of R? Find. Okay. Case 2. This question has been get 2009 examination, triple examinations. Third one, this question is as in ISRO 2015 examinations. Case 1. Source have multiple voltage source and resistance. So convert this into a Thevenin's resistance. When RTH is equal to RL, the maximum power will be transferred. Fourth case. This is case 3. Load is impedance, but combinedly adjustable. Source also impedance. By using Thevenin's resistance, find the source impedance. When ZL is equal to complex conjugate of source impedance, maximum power will be transferred. This question has been IAS 2018 examinations. Okay, now all the questions. If you have an ability to solve all these questions, the work questions, then you can solve any type of questions from the maximum power transfer concepts. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon for notification. Like, comment, and share.